If I was to predict, this is actually going to get worse.
FAU's Harbor Branch Executive Director Jim Sullivan and epidemiologist Adam Schaefer are leading the charge to uncover the truth about the toxic algae blooms turning our waters green.
So we know what the short-term effects for exposure, particularly to the red tide bloom, are. The big missing piece is what are the long-term effects of exposure. So we're collecting samples from individuals where we're taking a nasal swab, we're taking a blood sample, and a urine sample, where we can actually measure some of the toxins that are produced. And then we're taking a questionnaire. So we're asking individuals where they live, where they've been exposed to the water, and tying that into questions about symptoms they might be experiencing, and then back to exposure. We're looking at admission rates in area hospitals during blooms and during non-bloom periods as well.
When you're talking with people and gathering samples, what are some common denominators that they're telling you that they're experiencing?
Eye irritation, nose irritation, cough.
I think we've finally hit a tipping point. We just can't ignore it anymore. We have to start studying it and understanding what it's doing to us and our environment.
Why did FAU take such an interest in researching the impacts of blue-green algae and red tide on the population here in Florida?
As state employees, you know, we can't be politically advocates for any particular way to fix it or any position politically for the problem, but it's an apolitical problem in that it affects everybody potentially. It doesn't matter if you're a Democrat or a Republican. We have established the Florida Center for Coastal and Human Health to aggregate our research, aggregate what we're doing, try to get as much collaboration as we can get going to really try to solve this problem. So I'm looking at FAU as being a leader in the state of Florida.
If things don't change, what does Florida's future have in store for it?
It could get to the point that people will not be able to go to the beaches. Real estate values around the water, our most expensive and prized real estate, will lose value. Tourism industry will incredibly suffer, and just the economy of Florida could be severely affected.
So do you have preliminary results as to how this is impacting humans long term?
We have been collecting data from humans, and they are in the process of being analyzed, and we are starting to get results. However, given that it's a human health issue, it has to go through the peer review system and be vetted out. And once it's gone through that, we will immediately release it to the public and let them know what we found.